this is Tony Lloyd. Being a broadcaster for many years, I've witnessed some great stories in the music industry, and now I want to bring as many music stories to you as I can in this series of podcasts. My goal is that they will inspire others making their way in the music world.
Music Stories with Tony Lloyd.
Maddox Jones, welcome to Music Stories. Thank you for talking to me.
Yeah, no, it's not. Thank you for having me.
Okay. Now, you've got your debut album out at the moment, which we'll talk about, obviously, and singles from it as well. But just a little bit of background about you first, if you'd be so kind. How did you get into music?
I was brought up in a Christian community, so we didn't have a TV or radio. We were encouraged to be quite creative, basically, as kids. So so from that I learned how to play guitar when I was 7, and then I was in my first band when I was 16, and just always love writing songs, really. So
fantastic. And what instruments do you play?
Play bass, guitar, keyboard. That's about it, really.
Okay, well, that's enough.
yeah.
I got to grade 5 piano. But it was so long ago, I can't even play chopsticks anymore. So so that's awesome. And you write all your own material, and you've written all the stuff on your new album called Believe It.
Yeah.
Which is great. I've dipped into it and had a listen. It's really impressive. I love it.
Cool, thanks a lot. Cheers.
No worries. Your voice is incredible. It's funny when you talk to somebody on an interview like this, you've no idea what their singing voice is like.
Yeah, because it doesn't sound the same, does it? Yeah,
no, yeah. You sound, if I may be so bold, a little bit Chris Martin-ish.
Okay, yeah, people say that. Yeah.
Do they?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's one of the biggest bands in the world.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's Coldplay are quite successful, I suppose.
Yeah.
So I think you should take that as a compliment anyway. It's not a problem sounding like somebody else, you know. I mean, you could have sounded like Elvis Presley or somebody, you know.
Yeah. To be fair.
Absolutely. Okay. So you've sort of been in the music industry all your life, and you've written your own stuff. You've played in other bands, haven't you? Tell me about the bands you've played in.
Yeah, 4 top 40 hits. We went on tour with Killers and played Reading, Glastonbury. That was when I first came out of uni. That was like 2000s. So, yeah.
What was it like playing with the Killers at Glastonbury? What was it like?
Yeah, great. Yeah, I mean, I've played a few times actually in different bands, but Glastonbury's like an awesome place. You meet so many cool people there as well. It's like everyone just go. I mean, have you ever been to festivals?
Me? No, I'm sadly not.
Well, yeah, it's like a great place. Like everyone, it's like an escape. Like people are just like escaping to a festival. You can just like relax, and yeah, it's great.
Is it muddy?
Yeah, it's muddy. Yeah.
So you've got to be prepared for the bad weather in England. Obviously, yeah. Okay, that's awesome. So your new single is Magic from the album. Tell me about that single and the idea behind it.
Magic is about a girl that you're kind of in awe of. You know, it's actually about my girlfriend, and it was about saying like, "Give me all of your magic," basically. So me and Hannah were like, we've been like dabbling in a bit of like magic, I guess. We've been like doing a bit of magic ourselves, so we kind of just got inspired by that.
It's in your bloodstream, right to your bones. It's been lying in wait since the day that you were born. It was there in the stories, there when you were a child.
What's her reaction to the single?
Yeah, she loves it. Yeah, she loves it. Yeah.
Well, that's a result then, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
A bit. I'm glad everything's okay and she appreciates the song. That's really good. Another track on the album, The Beautiful Soul, is about a breakup, isn't it?
Yeah, it's about a girl who I was going out. Well, I was with for like three or four years, actually. Yeah, a long time. And when we broke up, it was quite a hard breakup. So, I wrote that song, really.
And do you find that, you know, your writing is about your life experiences?
Yeah, it is, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, most people say that. And that's where their inspiration comes from as well.
But it's honest, isn't it? It's real.
Yeah, yeah. And is it, when you sing it, about a sad occurrence, is it difficult for you to sing emotionally?
No, I'm probably disconnected from that. I've moved on, do you know what I mean, from that, yeah. I think. Like, yeah, I think you have to, maybe I should, like, get back into that place when I sing it. It might be more, might connect with people more.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah. It's hard, yeah, I think, like, because it was so long ago.
Yeah.
About it.
It always, dare I mention ABBA? You know, and some of their songs are about their breakup periods and everything else, and they sing it all so emotionally and professionally, you know, and I don't know how they can do it, but I suppose it's the same thing. They sort of have to detach yourself from the emotion and just get on with the singing.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, ABBA have created some amazing songs, haven't they?
They have, yeah.
Their melody. Like timeless. Like I actually read. Well, I know when I watched them in, and it said that they wrote like not like some of their biggest hits, like in just like a two-week period. Yeah. Like, yeah. So
it's incredible, isn't it? And you often find that people like Elton John sit down at the piano and write a hit in 5 minutes. You know.
Yeah.
And Barry Gibb did the same with the Bee Gees. And,
yeah.
Yeah, incredible. Incredible. Very talented. How long does it take you to write a song then?
Depends. I've written songs like, there's one on the record, God Damn I'm Happy. That took like 5 minutes.
Wow.
Sometimes they take a bit longer. Like normally the second verse like takes a bit longer. You get the first verse to the chorus and then like, I'll get a bit bored. So I have to come back to the second verse. And so that takes a bit longer, but...
And do you write the music first or the words first, the lyrics?
Both the same. Like I'm on the piano, so they come at the same time, really.
All right, that's quite unusual.
Yeah,
that's quite cool. I like that. I like that idea. And then sort of you sort out both sides of the song at the same time, which is quite cool.
Kind of, yeah.
That's good. What advice would you give to other musicians like you who? Go on.
Don't do it.
Don't make do sure it. You've got
another, make sure you've got another job.
Get a proper job.
You have to rely on the ego. I'd say advice, like, yeah, I mean, look, music's some people that do music like me, like, it's just in me, it's what I do. I don't really see it as a career choice. Mm. It's like a vocation, really. It is a career choice, but it's just something that that I'll always do. Like, I think success will come in waves. Sometimes you'll have a bit down periods. Sometimes you'll have up periods. But just keep going, really, yeah. So keep trucking.
That's good. That's good advice. Eddie Kendricks, keep on trucking.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Great track. Okay, for you, what's the future? I mean, you've got this debut album out now.
Yeah, I'm going to be playing some shows. Got a collaboration I'm working on. With a dance producer, just cracking on, really. Yeah, just carrying on.
That's good. My music. It sounds like fun.
Yeah.
And is there another album on the horizon, do you think?
Yeah, it will be, but give me a chance.
Yeah, I know. No pressure. No pressure. Come on, hurry up. Yeah,
I think your first one's out. You're like, where's the next one?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sure that'll be next year or something, hopefully. I'll try and do an album a year.
Well, that's good. Okay. And how about gigs and performances and stuff like that? Are you getting...
Yeah, Janet Devlin on tour at the end of April, playing Glasgow Hug and Pint on the 25th. Yeah, a few bits, really. So
that's really good. Fantastic. Well, I wish you all the best. Thank you very much for talking to me on Music Stories. And good luck with the release of Believe It, the new album. We'll put a little link in the text of the podcast so people can find you.
Yeah, great.
And thanks again. Thanks again for talking to me.
Yeah, nice one. Thanks for having me.
Music Stories is a free podcast with no fees paid to contributors in the hope that it'll help and inspire others in the music industry. Get in touch if you've got a story to tell. If you would like a professional podcast made or would like training so you can do it yourself, I can help. Go to TonyLloydRadio.com.
Music Stories with Tony Lloyd.